from WFAA-TV, the spirit of Texas. This is Good Morning Texas in high definition.
You know what I'm talking about. 35 million men, all with one big problem: hair loss. But thanks to new technology, they're seeing growth in a whole new light. Dr. Mark Bishara with Paragon Plastic Surgery is here this morning to tell us more about the Artis hair transplant and how it's transforming lives. Welcome. So nice to have you with us.
Thank you very much, Jane.
Okay, 35 million men, a lot of suffering from hair loss. How does the Artis procedure change it?
Sure. Well, when a man suffers from hair loss, we can use a robotic arm. The Artis system is a robotic, physician-assisted robotic arm that allows us to go through and take out hair and place it into areas where he's lost hair.
Okay, obviously this is a concern to a lot of men because it can be a blow to self-esteem.
Absolutely. Having hair is a secondary sexual characteristic, and it's sort of associated with a man's vitality. And not having hair and then not having it later on in life is really a big blow to a man's self-esteem.
Okay, this is the first and only FDA-cleared robotic hair transplant system, I believe.
That is correct.
Tell us how it works.
Sure. Well, it starts off by getting the patient very comfortable. So usually we're giving that patient a little bit of anesthetic by mouth, and we put them into the robot where the robot can actually analyze the density, the distribution, the different direction of the hairs. It actually goes through and it will set some parameters of that patient's scalp. We'll dissect out the grafts, we'll place the patient, once we're completed, into a different chair, and then manually put those grafts into the holes.
That's fascinating how, technology, we can do so many things today. How long does it take?
Well, so Artis procedures can range. They can be as quickly as an hour and a half to 2 hours, on up to about 8 hours. And the longer procedures, it's important to understate too that those patients are comfortable during the entire time. We take periodic bathroom breaks. We will even break for lunch. And
wow.
Typically, the beginning of the day is usually spent sleeping from some of the mild anesthetics that we use. And then the latter half of the day, once we're planting the grafts, that's usually spent watching Netflix or being sort of in a comfortable environment where they can continue to sleep or catch up on some binge watching.
And you're talking about being able to relax, watch TV. You say it's not painful like some other procedures?
That is correct. One of the big pros to using a robot to dissect out the grafts or even using a follicular unit extraction technique is the lack of pain. So we do give a little bit of Valium at first, and we'll use some similar to Botox needles to apply a nerve block. And then it's very rare at the conclusion of the procedure that the patient would have to take some form of a narcotic for pain control, either that night or even the next day.
What's recovery time?
So recovery time is split into two different types of recovery. So you have one that's called physiologic downtime. So that's typically nothing to increase your heart rate or your blood pressure for about a day and a half, so the remaining part of the day, and at plus one more day. And then something called social downtime. So we call social downtime just sort of, having maybe some scabbing or some redness in the areas where
right.
we were working. So that typically is about 3 to 5 days on up to about a week. If you're from Northern European descent with some really light skin tones, you might hold on to some redness for 10 days or so.
So when is the patient going to see new hair growth?
Right. So it's very rare that someone would see hair growth within the first 6 months, but certainly by about month number 7 through 9, we start to see hair grow in the recipient side areas that we've planted. And certainly by 10 to 12 months, we'll see that about 90% of what we've transplanted is now available.
And is the new hair growth definitive?
It is. Hair transplantation is really the only definitive solution for hair loss. We should try to steer away from the word permanent because nothing in this world is permanent, but there is an issue of something called senescence out there where over time, over 30 or 40 years, it may not necessarily be permanent, but it may thin out.
And you said there's no linear scarring.
That is correct. So, the days of old, 15, 20 years ago, where we took out a strip of scar in the back, a strip of scalp in the back, and then used that for transplant are behind us now. Now we're taking individual grafts sort of from ear to ear, And that allows us to distribute these very tiny little holes throughout the whole back part of the scalp, and you can't really tell. And that's one of the big pros to this procedure, one of the advantages.
Interesting information. Thank you so much. Okay, so if you're interested in this, log on to artishair.com or markbasharamd.com to take the first steps to a full head of hair.